And now, Magic 107.3 pays special tribute to rhythm and blues artist, rhythm and blues legend, rhythm and blues superstar, the candy licker, Marvin Sease.
Girl, you said you want me. You say you want me to be your man. Yes, you did. And you said you want me. You say you want me. You want me to marry you. I don't mind doing that, baby, but there is something. There is something I think I better tell you right now. I'm just a ghetto man. That's all I am. Singing it. This ghetto town.
Of leaving either one of them. You know what? would really blow their mind. Y'all, I'm stuck. Ah, y'all, I'm in the middle tonight. I'm stuck, baby. Oh, I'm stuck in the middle.
Magic 107.3. It's all the blues that you can use. And a bit more at 12 minutes now. 12 minutes past the 11 o'clock hour. On the telephone lines now we have Mark Sease. The late Marvin Sease's son, Mark. Mark, are you there?
Yes, I am. How you doing?
I'm doing fine, Mark. Our sincere prayers and our condolences goes out to
Jackson, Mississippi, this Wednesday, mm-hmm. with the actual funeral service, East Road, Denmark, South Carolina. That's 5573 Voorhees Road in Denmark, South Carolina. And once again, that's on the campus of Voorhees College. It has the Leonard E. Dawson written all over the building. Just get to Denmark and ask somebody, anybody, if you're interested in coming. Rick, if you don't mind, I like to clear something up. A lot of people don't understand about, and they was wondering why we didn't have the services in Charleston.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to take this time, if you don't mind, and let me explain to them.
Please do. Go ahead.
At his wishes, he wanted it to have something in Charleston. But for two reasons, at the last minute, as when I spoke to him, he couldn't have it because he wanted to be buried next to his father. His father's burial site, grave site, is in Earhart, South Carolina. So having a funeral service all the way in Charleston and to have the people to drive that far away is just too far.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't want to inconvenience. That's the way that he is. That's the way he's always been.
Mm-hmm.
He never wanted to inconvenience nobody. If he could bring it to you, then he would bring it to you. But he don't want you to have to come too far away for nothing. That's the way he's always been.
Mm-hmm.
And also, it was just no place that was big enough to have the event, you know, to have the services. So we needed a place to hold a few thousand people. So we because we know it's going to be a lot of people there, and there's no big enough place that was willing to work with you anyway. And I needed something close to home anyways, as people know, he was born in Blacksville, South Carolina. Mm-hmm. Blacksville is only 7 miles away from Denmark, so that's just like home to him. Mm-hmm. So, but he was raised in Charleston, and, you know, so we had to do what was best for him, but most of all, is what he requested. Mm-hmm. So, and so that was a decision. It was an easy decision to make. Mm-hmm. A hard one, but an easy one.
I understand.
But so I hope everyone could understand and why he didn't have it in Charleston.
Okay. Okay. No problem. Now, he's done, how many albums did he record?
17 albums.
A lot of albums. A lot of folks did not know that he recorded. I do. I did. But a lot of folks didn't know that he recorded that many albums. A lot of folks know my ties with your dad and you. And we go back. we go way back. And somewhat we did stay in touch. But I want to say this. And you can remember this. Years ago, back during the... the late 80s, I used to play at Peter Miller Party Barn every Saturday night for years. And that's how I met your dad. And I was over at WPL doing the Midday Madness at that time. And he would come out on Sunday nights, and he would be on my show, and he would sing. And he gave me the first album, Marvin Sease, the album. And the track that I got on was Ghetto Man.
Oh, yeah.
And it did real well for him. And 1 year, just about a year from that date, he called me up and he said, Frankie, I want to come back home. I want to do a show in Charleston at the auditorium. He says, now, I want you to do something that you've never done before. He says, I'm going to put it in your hand. I want you to promote it. I want you to MC the show. I'm going to bring Roy C., Tyron Davis on the show. And the show was in about 2 weeks. Am I right? It was about a complete sellout. Now, and I tell a lot of folks when I talk about the show business thing, the action and the fun is really backstage. But that night, he was literally shaking. We were a little upset because there were so many people at the Gilead Municipal Auditorium, and we actually thought that we thought the fire marshal was going to shut us down, but they didn't. And that was an awesome show, and he gave me the privilege to be on the show, not only as the MC, not only to promote it, but I opened up this show that night, and it was awesome. It was awesome, and from there I was able to MC a lot of his shows. And whenever he came around the Charleston area, he wanted me to MC the show. And there was one of them I just could not make. And he says, "What? You mean to tell me I'm coming to Charleston and you can't even see my show?" I said, "Marvin, this is one that I just cannot do."
Right. I tell you one thing. If it's anyone, any promoter that's doing a show, a blues, soul, R&B show, if it's in South Carolina, if it's anywhere that your station can be reached, he's going to tell you to advertise with you. I can guarantee you right now.
I know. He did. Yes, he did.
Gary Entertainment is doing a show in Columbia, where he's supposed to have been on with the Manhattans and everybody, and Mel and all of them. And if I'm not mistaken, y'all running spots on that show, right?
Yes, we are. Mm-hmm.
Right. He told him to make sure that you use Frankie Station. I don't care if it's in Charleston.
Yeah.
People, if they hear about it, they're going to come.
Yeah.
So I could say one thing, he loved and respected you and couldn't keep your name out of his mouth.
I know. I truly missed him. I miss him. When I was putting that tribute together, it was a real, real hard thing to do. But anyhow, we know, you know, that's going to come. We don't know when it's going to come, but we never prepared for it.
Right.
But anyhow, I know that
I'm going to make sure his name stays alive, so, you know, everybody just look out in the future, just keep your ears pierced. I'm going to keep his name going.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Maybe gone from us, but he won't be forgotten.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to see to it that his legend stays alive.
Okay. All right. Okay, Mark, I'm going to...